Yeah, you know, every cubic inch of this soil right here is teeming with millions of inches of mycelium. And all around us, even though you can't see them, there are fungi growing everywhere.
A walk through the woods in Green Island, New York is pure pleasure. But when you're with two barely 30-year-old geniuses like Gavin McIntyre and EBEN Baer,
there's a piece of fungi there.
You're sure to stumble on something scientifically complex.
And you can see the mycelium growing directly into the log.
And chances are, it somehow involves a mushroom.
We're here at Ecovative Design, and I'm one of the co-founders and chief scientists here at this really, truly revolutionary new biomaterials company, where we're taking local farm waste, mixing it with tissue from mushrooms, and growing replacements for plastic foams that are used in protective packaging.
And why is this so important? Like, what's the problem with styrofoam?
There's about $10 billion to $20 billion of styrene products used globally, from packaging to building construction to automotive. It's not like plastics equals bad. It's that they're fundamentally incompatible with the Earth's biosphere.
Here are a couple of pieces of polystyrene. We've all seen these before. Almost every big product we buy comes packaged in this material. But here's the problem with it. These are made from unsustainable petrochemicals, and it can take up to a million years, maybe even more, for this material to biodegrade and leave the Earth.
So we use a combination of agricultural waste, like corn husks and mushrooms, as a resin. And we combine these two together, and we grow them in a mold to make a shape for everything from packaging to auto parts.
A mushroom that you see growing out of the side of a tree is entirely comprised out of mycelium. But if you were to look into that tree structure or along the forest floor, what you'll find is a vast network of these unicellular strands, little fibers that are growing through the soil of the environment as well as in trees. And that's what's really gluing a mushroom, say, onto the side of a tree or to the forest floor.
And do you guys grow your own mushrooms?
One of our keys is we actually never grow mushrooms. We just keep the mycelium in this vegetative growth stage where it's always making more of this root structure. The initial concept of using mushroom roots or mycelium as a resin was inspired when I saw mycelium growing through wood chips and holding them together. But the combination with agricultural waste as a feedstock didn't come till much later after I teamed up with Gavin.
This is where it all starts, with this farm waste.
It actually takes close to 7 days for a product to be grown from beginning to completion. But we're about to show you how it works in seconds.
Gavin, what is all this?
The waste is first cleaned right before adding the mycelium. Then it gets incubated for about 2 to 3 days, and it becomes a solid white mass. Next, it goes through a trommel, a machine that grinds the waste.
This is reminding me of Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, and I'm afraid I'm going to get sucked up in the trommel.
Grinding it into a type of mulch so it can be packed into the molds. The molds are then stacked and left for another 3 days, where the mycelium does what the mycelium does, grow. All that's left is to bake it at a low temperature of 200 degrees to stunt the growth of the mycelium.
Freshly baked fungus.
So it can be sold to corporations like Dell Computers and other Fortune 500 companies.
But here's what's really cool about mushroom packaging. I can take this packaging material and actually bury it in my yard, and within a couple of months, it will biodegrade. And not only that, but add valuable nutrients to the soil.
Ecovative is about to begin large-scale manufacture of plastic-free products. And the possibilities go far beyond protective packaging. They are now developing home insulation.
Do you guys feel like you're having an impact on humanity?
Yeah, well, you know, really, we see this as looking forward centuries, not just days. And we want to make sure that this environment is available for our grandchildren and our grandchildren's children, and that we're taking best use of the natural resources that are provided us today.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology, it's a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.